Good morning, students, and welcome to our e-learning session. But it's now again we are on online lectures. So it's a wonderful and a pleasant morning, and I wish that as we have started our online lectures from Monday, so you all have attending this online lectures regularly. So dear students, before we start a new topic, new talk, new knowledge, let's talk on the current news, you know, a wonderful news for our country. As yesterday was 10th of January and the booster dose has started in our country. Remarkable achievement for our country. Yes, so wonderful things are going, and we pray Almighty that all things will go smoothly and nicely. So my dear student, if you have seen on the board a wonderful quote what I have mentioned related to today's topic. As you remember, on Saturday we discussed about the chapter number 7. Yes, so in chapter number 7, a wonderful like topic and the point what we have discussed about the Gandhiji and the Gandhian age, that is what we discuss about the following the Mahatma, and that was the part 1. Yes, so today what the thought, like, you know, which come in my mind was the problems are nothing but wake up call for creativity. Problems are nothing but wake up calls for creativity. So always we have to think in a positive manner. One problem what now we are facing due to this pandemic, that most of the time, or the smaller one like you, we have to stay at home and we have to study. So in that manner, this is the problem might be. But here, the thing what we will keep in mind, as you are the student of Shri Gyan Manjari Secondary School, we are absolutely different from others. So our mindset, our thinking must be in the different manner. So this problem is for us, it must be the wake-up call for the creativity. So here we have to be more creative. We will perform in a best way and in a different way. Again, we will going to learn number of things, the same content what others friend from different schools are learning. But here we are the student of Gyan Manjari, so we are more creative. So in that way, we will going to learn, we will going to talk, and in a different and in beautiful manner. So think out why I have written this quote. I start with the problem. So in this chapter number 8, we are going to talk about the problems. Yes, few problems according to, like, you know, we can say this is a challenges. So the challenges which we are facing in our country. Obviously, India is a Vishwa Guru. As in Sanskrit we say, is na bhuto na bhavishyati. Yes, but number of problem that what we are facing, and in this chapter we will going to talk about few of the problems, not all, but a very important, or the problem which have a great impact on our social economical life. So that what we will going to talk today. So our chapter is India, challenges and solutions. As any challenges, if we say, if we are using the word challenges, it will have solution. If we use any word, any situation, as if it is a challenge, then definitely there will be the solution. So in this chapter, we will going to talk about number of challenges with the solving, with the solution. So our chapter number 8 is actually related on the economical part. In social, if we particularly talk, then we have to relate it with the economy. Number of the problems, what we will going to discuss with its solution. So our chapter number 8 is India, challenges and solution. Number of challenges we are facing, like internal problems, regional problems also, even the border problem. As you know, we are having 8 neighboring countries or 9. We are having land boundaries we are sharing with Pakistan, Afghanistan, Nepal, Bhutan, Burma, that is what we say is Myanmar, Bangladesh and Maldives, and the Sri Lanka are our neighboring countries. So we are having the border problems also. And the natural problems, yes, it's a very, like you know, that it's a very obvious that the all part in world, every country is facing, but India, this is for us, it's a major challenge also. So in the modern time, the external mean of develop had changed. Yes, so but the internal means of development had more or less remained the same. In internal, few problems are always remain the same. Since we got independence in 1947, from there, as India is a developed nation. Yes, a developing, we are the developing country. So still we are having number of internal problem. Here you can say I have mentioned a few one, that the overpopulation, illiteracy, inflation, poverty, unemployment, urbanization, communalization, corruption and terrorism. These all are the very few, but it is having the great impact on our society and in our development. So honesty, moral values, awareness towards the rights and duties of the citizen, traffic awareness, sensitivity towards the environment, scientific attitudes have not developed as much. So the material development, so social level like the superstitious, illiteracy, ignorance still prevail in our society. This all point, if you remember, and we are discussing very frequently in our social lectures. So this all are the few challenges still what we are facing in our country. If we want to make the development, still India is a developing country, still we have to make some progress, still we are left behind with the things. So if we come out with these challenges, definitely again we, like, we can prove ourselves as a Vishwaguru, or we can prove that India is a developed nation. So institution of the local self-government, yes, like Gram Panchayat and municipal corporations, and that even the educational institution and the non-government voluntary organization, that what we say is the word NGOs. What is the full form of NGOs? This is the non-government voluntary organization. And they have played a vital role in the ensuring the social and professional development of the nation. See, all these local self-governments or the NGOs or the educational institute or individual, we want, we wish that our country make a development, and we all are working forward it. So the society shows many positive changes, which is very credible fact. So still there are many more challenges still to be faced. So the, we can say the pollution, unemployment, poverty, illiteracy, terrorism are the serious problem. The country is facing this type of a serious problem, and it is having the great and the major impact also. So it is necessary to think about them and find a solution also. Yes, so the idea of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, The term in Sanskrit what we use that the Vasudeva Kutumbakam, in term of social we can say it's a globalization. As now entire world is one nation, one like a family, we are depend on other countries. So Vasudeva Kutumbakam, the whole earth is my family, need to be inculcated. So here we as a citizen, as responsible citizen, we have to understand the challenges and we have to make effort to come out from this challenges. Now here only one criteria I have mentioned on right now. Yes, so if we talk about the classification of challenges faced by India, it is not so that the internal challenges we are facing, even we are facing the regional problems, like India is a state of unions. Yes, so different 28 states and the union territories, and within the states we are having multiple problems. So that what we say is the regional problems, like discrimination based on the languages. Say for we are Gujarati speaking, we are Gujarati speakers, and the Maharashtra is our neighboring state, they are the Marathi speaking people. So again we are having discrimination that we are better than others. So this type of the discrimination what we face, and the regionalism. Yes, so the state is far better than other, and so on. Border problem, as I said, as I mentioned, as India is a vast country with a vast geographical scenario. Yes, so we are having number of issues with our neighboring country like the China and Pakistan. So we have to resolve it also. And natural problem, as I have mentioned, like we have studied, like earthquake, tsunami, famine, drought, volcanic eruptions, the cyclone, this all are the natural disaster. Like, you know, we can't stop it, we can't control it. But if we are having a good knowledge, we can save ourselves from the major destruction or disaster. So this all are the classification, what it is mentioned in your material, what it is given in your syllables. So now we will going to talk about the few of the challenges. Here this all challenges are very important. Keep in mind that this all challenges, we have to understand, now the problem is with us, now we have to come up with the solution. Okay. So let's talk on few of the challenges, the major challenges what our country is facing. First of all, let's talk about the overpopulation. The first challenge what we have to focus is about the overpopulation. So this is the first point what we have to talk. Overpopulation, janagana, jansankhya. Okay, so as you all know that India is the second largest populated country in the world. Yes, it's a fact. We are the second largest populated, most populated country in the world. So our country, number of the student might be visit to the city like Delhi or Mumbai or the Ahmedabad. You will feel that it's overcrowded. Yes, as it is having the large population, so number of places it's like a overcrowded. Even on our earth, it's really very crowded. Yes, number of people are not getting enough food, enough water, even the shelter facilities. As they are deprived from this thing, as we are having the overpopulation. So this is the major issue, not only our country, but like even the China is facing the same problem. Okay, so we can say due to this overpopulation in our country, number of challenges, like due to the overpopulation, those who are able to earn or those who are financially capable, they can eat or they can fulfill their basic requirement. even the space is limited, geographical situation is limited, or the area it is limited. But as it is overcrowded, you will feel the mass. Even it's a very difficult to control the situation. As we are having a large number of citizens, yes, so number of financial, health issue, and economical problem we have to faces. Here a wonderful activity is given. So first of all, write this. Make a list of crowded places you have observed, and what is your observation. So please write, this is your first task of the day of this lecture. And yes, you have to submit this work in the given period of time to your respective associate teacher. I'm not going to write in a board, as you have to be very much attentive. You must be attentive in your online lectures. So first activity, you have to mention in your homework book. You have to write activity 1 for this lecture. Make a list, please write it. Make a list of crowded places you have observed, and write your observation. Which place you have visited and what is your observation? See, here you have to make a comparison. Say for we are living in Bhavnagar. Bhavnagar is a small city compared to Ahmedabad, compared to Mumbai, compared to Delhi. So what type of differentiate you have seen over there? So here you have to make a list of the crowded places, what you have visited and what you have observed. So this you have to make and you have to write in your book. So in the previous chapter, if you remember, we have studied about the overpopulation and its effects also. Yes, so the root cause of almost all the problem is overpopulation. Why we took overpopulation as the first challenge? As number of the problem, most of the problem once we can say, most of the problems occur during the overpopulation. Due to the overpopulation, economical problem we have to face, social challenges we have to face, even the health issues, even the medical problems and the challenges, that what we have to face it. So this is the first and utmost important or the internal problem what we are facing. So in the previous, like as I said, in the previous chapter we have already discussed with this point of the overpopulation in chapter number 6, in what you were you made the chart also. Yes, so now we have to think about the way to control the population. Now how can we control the population? So that or there are number of schemes and the ways by government is working on it. So increase in the population means the increase in the demand for facilities. Now see, what is a small example, if I'll give you the example. If you are having a fine good pizza, medium size of pizza, and you and your brother or sister, you only are two to eat it. So definitely you will get a half of the proportion. But if you are, you have to share with the 3, 4 or more than that, then obviously you will get a less amount, demand will be more. So this all of the economical concept, when the supply is limited, natural resources are limited, goods and services or the resources are limited in proportion, but our demand will be more. So everyone can't fulfill their requirement, or we can't meet to basic demand. So that is the utmost challengeable job for government. So increase in population means increase in demand for facilities and infrastructures. Okay, so population growth overgrowth the growth of economy. In other word, the population growth is more and faster than the growth of economy. We can't establish the factories or we can't fulfill our basic demand on as fast as how the population is increasing. So there will always scarcity of the demand, and that is the basic or the root problem of number of challenges. See, another activities it is given in the page number 63 that you have to prepare a graph. In maths though you all are using the graph, isn't it? So it says, dear student, this is all subjects are interrelated. Here again you have to prepare a graph. So what you have to prepare? See, on x-axis and the y-axis, obviously on graph, when you will prepare a graph, you have to make x-axis and the y-axis. So prepare the graph showing the population increase from 1951, from where 5-year planning commission has started. So prepare the graph showing the population increase from 1951 to 2011, as last census was done in 2011. If you remember this point also, we have discussed in the class, you remember? For chapter number 6, we have discussed this about the population and the gender ratio and the sex ratio, and that point we have discussed previously. So here, this is also the work that what you have to do, as it is a 5-10 minute of work. So this is your second task of this lecture. This is the second task of the lecture, that you have to prepare a graph. Take a fine graph, paste in your special book, paste in your special social book. And what you have to do, say for, take a proper scale. Obviously we have to take a proper scale. So here you can see that on the x-axis we have taken the year. So make a graph it, and you have to make it graphical representation. So I required that everyone should send this, huh? That is why this is very important. By social we can learn maths, by maths learning of the maths and the problem sums we can learn social. So it's all subjects are interrelated. So this is a wonderful activity. So here if you observe that in 1951 we are having 31.60 crore of population. We are talking about 60 year back our population was only 31.60 crore. Now in one decade, so in 1961 it increased by 43.92 crore. Again take a jump of 10 year. So let's talk on 1971. So at that time our population was 54.81 crore. Then in 1981 again it increased by 68.33 crore. In 1991 population was 84.64 crores. In 2001 you won't believe our population was 102 crore and 87 lakh. And in 2011, in last census, our population was 121 crore. Think out. And now if we are not mistaken, we are more than 135 crore. So just think out, in a 60 year, our population is more than 3 times, like, you know, it's increasing. So it's a really challengeable situation for our nation and for any government, as due to the high population, number of problems, number of things to be resolved. So according to the census in 2001, the total population in India was only 102 crores, and which in 2011 has gone up to 121 crore. So almost 20 crores, increasing of 20 crores. So it means there was an increase of 18.14 crores approx. So overpopulation led to the certain man-made challenges. What type of challenges we have to face? That is the first of the pollution. Will you believe this? Due to the population, pollution will increase, as the vehicles, number of vehicles will increase, requirement will increase, so the factory, there will be the like, you know, burden on the factories, and the due to the overpopulation, even the pollution will increase, congestion on the, in the residential area, shortage of water. Obviously, that water is the natural resources. It is having limited quantity it is having. And we as the user, we are the increasing like anything. So the shortage of water as well as the food, what we have to face. Even the medical services. Now see, dear student, as entire world is facing the pandemic, now we are having number of hospitals and the medical facilities we are having. But as we are, our country is highly populated. So it's very difficult to get the proper medical facilities to the poor one or those who are not the sufficient amount of the finance or the sufficient amount of the money. So unemployment is also one of the major issue or the major problem which arose due to the overpopulation. Even the education opportunities. See, you all are studying in one of the best school of the Gujarat. But all students, other children are not getting this opportunity. As due to the overpopulation, the unemployment problem will be there. And the parents, those who are not having the sufficient amount to earn or the sufficient, they are not earning a sufficient amount. They can't afford to keep their children in the one of the best school. So educational opportunities, even the unemployment, thousands and lakh of people are like, you know, they are not having any work to do. They are ready to do, but they do not have the option. They compulsory, they have to sit in their home. So this is also the one of the major issue. So even corruption, you might be have seen the movie like, you know, Gabbar. So at that time, you know, the problem of the corruption you have seen in that movie. Yes. So corruption, to do any work we are giving or anyone is taking unauthorized money, that what we say is the corruption. So the corruption, even the terrorism, like, you know, every day in a newspaper or news channel you are hearing about the terrorist attack in Kashmir or somewhere here or there. So this all are the challenges. This problem arose due to the overpopulation. The root cause is of overpopulation. So as now we understand that the overpopulation, due to the increase in population, number of social and financial problem will arose. So number of steps government have to take to control the overpopulation. Second major issue is illiteracy. Illiteracy means when any person is not able to read and write. See, as any language, as we are the, we can speak any language, but if we cannot read, write or speak, at that particular period of time, we have to consider him or her as a illiterate. Unpad, jisko hum kahenge, illiteracy. Unpad, the person who is illiterate, we consider him as a illiterate or unpad. So illiteracy is a major factor hindering the progress of the nation. See, when any person is literate, number of time you feel a busy schedule, a hard work, 8-10 hours you have to study. So number of the students, those who are not having the fine idea, he or she will ask why to study. What is the important to study? What is the importance of study? Why in our society, like since from Gurukul Pratha, the child have to go to, like, you know, we are going to school for what purpose? Now, if you remember in previous when we talk about the social level, like the Sati Pratha and the child marriage and Dut Piti and that, in that chapter we have learned that when any person is literate, when he or she is knowledgeable, the mindset or his thinking, his or her thinking power in the positive manner, he or she will always think nicely in the creative manner. So any nation, if they want to do their development, the basic requirement is literacy. As India is a overpopulated country, so due to this overpopulation, the problem arose of the illiteracy, saksharta ka problem. So an educational person can effectively communicate and explain his ideas, opinions, views and belief. Now see, you all are educated, so you all are having wonderful mindset. You always think, you will always think before what you do. As now you know what will be the effect, side effects, and what will be the problem and how to solve it. As now we are having the broader mind. So that is the benefit of to become the educated. So effectively communication we can make and explain our ideas, even the opinions, views and beliefs. So when we attained the independence, the literacy rate was quite low, as number of, like, you know, civil disobedient we have learned, different satyagraha we have talked. Even we know that at that time English schooling was started, but as we were not financially capable, all Indians, most of the Indians become very poor, and due to the number of reason, the literacy rate in 1947 was very low. At that time our this ratio was very low. So the literacy rate was quite low, but due to the effort of government, awareness towards the education has increased and the literacy rate has gone up in the country. Now again, number of time we talk on this also, we have discussed also, like, you know, Beti Bachao Beti Padhao Andolan, and number of, in almost all educational institute we are having reservation for particular caste and creed, even for the different religion they are having the different reservation in the educational institute. Why? To increase their knowledge, or they must take education. So government is taking number of different steps. See, in Things to Know it is given, Maharaja Sayaji Rao Gayakwad of Vadodara. You all have seen the Baroda. Yes, Baroda is the one of the big state where we have to consider it, and Maharaja Sayaji Rao Gayakwad was the king of the Baroda, and he made the primary education free and compulsory in the 19th century. Nowadays you are this word, it's very common to RTE, right? To Education Act. Yes, so even in the 19th century, our Maharaja Sayaji Rao Gayakwad was a visionary man. So he made the free and compulsory education in 19th century. Yes, you can't believe this. So in order to increase the literacy rate in his state, the area or the villages which comes in the under to the Baroda state, in that time Maharaja Sayaji Rao Gayakwad make the free and compulsory education for all. So even, and now the government is having the number of schemes, like we are having the law, like the RTE, so by which government is putting its best effort that all citizen of the nation, 6 to 14 year, all the children of the age of 16 to 14 must get education under this act. This is called the Right to Information Act. So number of provision is made by the government. So this is the second major problem or the challenges what we are facing. Now if you want to increase the literacy, then what we can do? So what is the solution, as we are talking about the problem? But here, with every problem, as I said, there will be the solution. So what is the solution, what we can do? See, you all are in class 8 and but might be it's may happen that you come across with the your friend or might be some toddler, that those who are not able to read or write, they never attend the school also. So what are the problem and what are the solution? So let's talk on the measure to increase the literacy. So we come across incidents when people get cheated because of their illiteracy. Number of time we have seen that as people are not able to read or write, they get cheated. So as they know they do not know the differentiate between the 500 and 5000 maybe, so they get cheated. So number of time the incidents also may happen that the people get cheated because of their illiteracy. Illiteracy is a taboo on the culture of the society and many measures have been taken to eradicate it. Now government is since 1947 we are doing only, government is making its best efforts. So this is what I said, Free and Compulsory Education Act, 6 to 14 year old students, all children must get the education. So free and compulsory primary education to age group of 6 to 14, it's come in under to the Right to Education Act. Right to Education Act. And free and compulsory primary education to age group of 6 to 14 years, and scholarship, midday meal, as the students, those who are coming from very lower class, from the deprived group, or the parents are very poor financially, they are not able to even give the food to their children. So here in this midday meal project, government is providing free healthy food to them also. Even pre-primary education, even for the girls, like the project like the Beti Bachao Beti Padhao, what they are having, each one teach one. So this is the one project was which was conducted by the government for the literacy campaigning. And since 2009 Right to Education Act must write it. Here you have to remember the year, short form and full form, both the abbreviation, and that you have to understand. Right to Education Act 2009. So each one teach one scheme, and since 2009 Right to Education, that is the RTE, have been introduced and implemented. Now find out the literacy rate of last 5 years. So students, again this is an activity. Yes, now again you are learning from your mobile, now it's a online learning, so this is very easy to do it. And this is a mathematical work. Now see, year of census is given, percentage of literacy given, and you have to come up with the percentage of literacy. Year is given, then the percentage is given, and you have to percentage of illiteracy. If say for an example, in 1971 literate person was 36.95%. Now you know we always take a percentage with a 100. So what is the way? Should I help you in this? As it is a mathematical calculation, but you required my help or you will do by yourself. I don't think it's a plus and minus. Simple equation, you have to do it. So what is the right way? You have to just 100 minus 36.95, the answer what you will get, that is a percentage of illiteracy. And you will find up to 1981 illiteracy rate is more than the literacy proportion. See, 100 minus 36.95, so it is all more than 50%. Okay, so what is the finest thing what you will do? Do it right now. Chalo, I am giving 1 minute to you. Do it. It's a simple sa plus and minus. So you all can do this. Do it right now. Let's try on the board. So this is a very simplest term. And simple, you have to minus literacy and illiteracy proportion. That is a very simple thing, what you can do it. In 1971, what it is given? We are talking about year 1971, and it is the percentage of literacy is given, that is a 36.95 it is a given, and we have to find illiteracy rate or illiteracy percentage. So simple, you have to minus from 100, and what answer you will get over here? The answer what you will get here, that is the percentage of illiteracy. That is the answer of illiteracy percentage in a year of 1971. So for 5 times you have to make addition and subtraction for 1971, 1981, 1991, 2001 and 2011. As every 10 year we are having the census, so this is the simplest term what you can do. Now it's a time for the some classwork and some work. This is the work what we have talked. 2 homework already I have mentioned, the activity base. Now I don't think you required my help to do this subtraction. I gave you the idea. I don't think that you required my help. This activity you have to do it, and right now you have to do it. And in next lecture we will come with the answers. In next lecture, when I start my next lecture, I'll ask you, I'll give the answer, and you have to check by yourself. And you have to, whether it is a correct or not, you have to check it. Okay, so this is the 2-minute work. Do it. You have to come up with the 1971, 81, 91, 2001 and 2011. And I don't think this is the way I show you. But subtraction you have to do. Don't wait for me. I will just give you the answers. It is a matter of 2 minutes, so don't take much time. Make it fast. We can't waste much of time. Okay. Chalo, let's write today's homework. As I have mentioned, 2 activity previously that you have to do it. So now on in every lecture, in between I will give some work. We will do something. Okay. So, okay, give me few answers. So let's write today's homework. Chalo, number 1. Who made free and compulsory education in Baroda when? Chalo, next question. Write this question first. Chalo, next question. Mention few internal problems faced by India. Anyone, what you like? Can anyone try to answer this? What is NGOs? What is NGOs? You have to specify what is a NGO. What is NGO? Let me know what is a NGO. So three question I am giving you right now. Two activities previously I have told you to do it in our special book. One, your observation. Second, the graph. And this is the homework. Okay. So first question, who made free and compulsory education in Baroda and when? Second question, mention few internal problems faced by India. And third question, what is NGO? So only three questions right now I am giving to you. Do it in your special book with a good handwriting, good work must be there. What is NGO? Okay. So this three question is your homework. Okay, do in the nice, in the presentable manner. Send your homework and on absolute perfect time. Yes, so in next lecture we will continue with some more problems with solution. It's a one fine line from your favorite serial, Tarak Mehta Ka Ulta Chashma. Problem hai, sabke saath, nazariye ki hai, baat. So we will talk about the solution. Okay. So here I am ending up this lecture. In next lecture we will continue this chapter. Thank you. Goodbye.